Howdy, folks. It's been a while. I've been focusing so much on this so-called virtual reality platform, and it's been a while I haven't uploaded any videos. That was for some of the viewers and subscribers. But anyway, I'm back again, and I'm going to hopefully be able to do and show you a lot of things. Now, as you can see, I am doing some improvement in my virtual reality with regards to ship familiarization or virtual tour in using computers and visors or the technology that we have on it. Although this is not all the technology, and for decades we have been using this already simulators in the maritime shipping business training, especially in the maritime training. But of course, with the advent of this going on with the pandemic or crisis, then we have shifted and somewhat adapted to other means of delivering instructional materials through virtual reality. But of course, it doesn't mean that this will replace the conventional teaching methodology, and still is the basic and very foundation of learning. Anyway, I'm here in the genome, actually entrance to the genome, and I have decided to include the genome as a part also of virtual familiarization. As you can see, this is a fallible purifier system, and piping has to be done, and as you can see, we have boilers here as well. The tanks for the bunker fuel oil and diesel oil are very visible. These are supposed to be covered with copper dumps cross compartment. This is the so-called CW close water expansion tank system. And of course, you can go down and still working on the texture of the materials. And here we have a control room. It's not yet done. We do have some panel boards, but we don't have yet the main console for the engine. So anyway, this will be of course completed. Likewise, we have air compressors, but this will be replaced with a more realistic 3D shown in this in my background with the tank reservoir. And of course, we have a escape trunk, and there will be a ladder, and there will be an interactivity wherein the user, or like the trainee, can actually get into that escape trunk and be able to get out from that direction. We have the diesel generator sets, and so now I have completed putting in the cooling system for the closed loop press water and sea water. These are the post system. Of course, there will be a lot of texture will be replaced. Lubrication and POL system will also be included in that part. So, just hopefully that there will be a lot of time to do so. This is a press water generator. It's a model pattern to Warsila, made in Warsila, but I'm not affiliated with that company. And just to some idea. And here we have the cooling system for the main engine. We have the seawater and the closed loop press water system. As you can see, we have the pumps that comes from the bottom of the chest. Of course, there will be a lot of there is a lot of work to do here. Lubrication system, fuel system, injection, and air supply or compressed air for the starting of the engine will also be fitted in this. And as you notice also, there are no stanchions or brackets that holds the pipe. So in reality, those will sag and eventually will break. You would also notice that the lighting fixtures, ventilation and pipe ducts, including electrical cables, are not yet in place. But we'll try to do our best that it would be very realistic. So you can even see there the number. See that number? And the texture is quite good, but it affects also the performance. There are a lot of things to do so in this kind of rendition or rendering of virtual reality. Underneath is the build's tank, that blank and the hole, and this is the oily water separator. Let's take a look. Stair system is to be accessible. This is the build's tank still floating. Some brackets will be put into that area also. It's a cooling system for the engine. Fresh water, still there is a lot of things to be rectified. Like for that one, the plants is not aligned. So these are the things that I have to make sure that it will be more done in a more cleaner. So this is a seawater pump for the cooling system. As you can see that this is a one-way thermo valve, and you probably saw already the other one. It's a three-way thermo valve. And again, as I mentioned earlier, irrigation and fuel oil system will be this. Likewise, any other stuff. Basically, all parts of the engine room will be rendered in virtual reality and with 3Ds and walkthrough. And some of them will be so-called interactive. You can use goggles or visors, and some of them will be through keyboard. This will be launched online, and it will be accessible in a certain website. And we will be featuring different kinds of ships model, anything from this one's a general bulk cargo ships, conventional designs. The engine is almost the same conventionally, but of course when we are dealing with other ships like dual fuel diesel engine or the electric engine or the LNGs, this of course a different layout inside of the engine. So a lot of things can be done, but it takes some time. Right, even the inside of the accommodation, actually, we are somehow I'm not getting it. It's even a wrong spelling there. Just mess. Soap room, safety room, firefighting room, and things like that. Even the garlic. There's a lot of things to be done here, like the colors, of course, things like that. Safety firefighting rooms, etc., and so on and so forth. Yeah, lots of stuff. And like I mentioned, this can be interactively manipulated or simulated through keyboards and buttons and similar stuff. You can control it using hand devices. This can be also what you call that mix with the mixed reality, as we call it, or the XR, the VR, and the so-called augmented reality. They can all be integrated into one. Markings, drops as well, all around the ship. And you can use a boat while alongside the pier, and that boat you can actually go around, and from the pier or wharf you can board the boat, the tugboat, and go around the vessel and do the dropping. So things like that. It's quite interesting. That's why I haven't uploaded much of this, because I've been in depth into this kind of development for a while, and it takes a lot of time and effort to do so. So keep posted, and Of course, for the rest of the lectures that I have mentioned earlier, like for the LPG, continuation of LPG operations and tank operations. Of course, the engine side a while ago that I have shown you, I'll be lecturing also some of those, like the cooling system of the engine and oil water separator system, turbine system, but as a facilitator. But I'll be using virtual reality, and in parallel to that, I'll be using genuine videos from onboard ships, from the engine room, and the website. Right, cheerio.